Welcome back. Despite the government's 34,000 crore farm loan waiver announcement, Maharashtra has reported more than 670 farmer suicide cases until September this year. Now, in Aurangabad district alone, official figures show that at least 100 farmers committed suicide. Amita, Balachandra traveled to the interiors of Maharashtra to find out why farmers are increasingly being forced to take this step.
Year-old Arunabhai Lakshman Malkar's husband Lakshman Karbari Malkar committed suicide 5 months ago in Aurangabad after failing to repay his crop loan, leaving Aruna with a debt of more than 2 lakh rupees and 3 children to take care of.
काय कर्ज होतं त्यांच्यावर त्याच्यानंतर मग त्यास केलते ना आणि मग नंतर त्याच्यानंतर आम्ही त्या माणसाला दिलं होगे वावर दिलं होतं नंतर त्यांना असं केलं होतं पण आता कोण नाही घरात लगेच करायला कोण नाही मी एकटीच आहे ना छोटे छोटे बच्चे आहे माझ्या माग मुलगा किती का 8 वर्षाचा आहे माझा पण तरी मी तो असं करू आला ना अजून असेच एक घरचे माणसं करते ना बाहेरचे शेती इथे सगळं पुतणे आमचे ते करते सगळं पोरं शेती मग मजुरी करते मग पोराला खाऊ घालते
Lakshman Malkar had a bank loan of 70,000 rupees and had borrowed 3 lakh rupees through private lenders. So even after Aruna got 1 lakh rupees from the government after her husband committed suicide, she still has private loans to repay.
आता बाहेरचं राहिले अजून समजा हे जे समजा कर्ज होतं समजा सोसायटीचं याचं आता हे सगळं सरपंचांना त्यांना साथ देऊन समजा करून दिलं माफ पण मग आता हे जे बाहेरचं आहे असं तुमच्या मायासारख्याचं ते राहिले अजून सरपंचाची खूप साथ आहे माझ्या माणसाची पण खूप साथ आहे तरी पण तो आम्हाला एवढ्याला सुद्धा ते करणं नाही त्याच्यामुळं माझा पती जाऊन सुद्धा तरी तो समजा आम्हाला अजून सुद्धा पिक्चर सोडेन नाही
Aruna says she cannot expect much from her 3-acre farm where she grows cotton. This year, she will not even get the 5 to 6,000 rupees per quintal of cotton because they haven't been able to grow anything due to no rains.
In Tar Pimpalgaon village of Aurangabad district, 30-year-old Aruna Malkar's husband committed suicide right at this field which they own, about 2.5 acres near that particular tree that you're looking at this point. After failing to repay his loan, Aruna tells us that he had a couple of loans along with the government, a bank loan and some private lenders who had lent him a loan. However, after failing to repay that, he committed suicide. Aruna, of course, tells us that she is the only person to run her household at this point in time. This is the particular field that you'll see that they own. However, they are unable to grow anything this year, considering there has been insufficient rainfall. They generally grow maize and cotton in this field, but considering there has been insufficient rainfall because of drought, she says that she's not been able to grow anything. She has to make a living out of going to different fields, to different people's homes and earning money to feed her children and her home.
Politicians, on the other hand, agree that this year could be worse with the region facing drought. They say, however, that there could be other reasons for farmers' suicides not going down.
Many time opposition says because of loans they are suicide. If they, now we have given them a, such a huge 33,000, till today not a any government in the country has given so much such a huge waiver of loan. After that also there are many different reasons we are trying to find out and we are trying to work out and trying to educate the farmers and all. This is not the way you should increase your productivity, you should increase your, there are different ways by which you can improve your thing.
Loan waiving is another part and whatever they have got a loan not in the from the, when there is no loan waiving, they have got a loan from somebody else, from private. That is also not a bothersome for them. It is years together, that is a practice. But there is no crop, nothing has happened, nothing, they see nothing, everything is zero. Forget about the central, I am not expecting anything from the central. Okay. If it comes, I am happy.
While Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis announced that 180 tehsils are facing a drought-like situation, farmers only hope they receive financial help from the government quickly. With video journalist Sachin Yeram, Amita Balachandra, Mirror Now.